easy to ban. That is the main.
When you first get a property, it's a very beautiful property, but hasn't been well taken care of. So during we then draw a plan, and we decide to keep the birds only at the first part of the building, and the rest of it, it'll be going to is to turn into a discovery center to tell people about swiftlet, because swiftlet in the past has been a mystery to a lot of people.
Not an easy industry actually, as a wildlife, they live on insects. They are very sensitive. We as human beings, we are building breeding houses, hope to attract them in. So the success rate is not high. Old houses is perfect for them. New houses, new buildings actually is a challenge to attract them in. So that is a fact that many people has not understand that.
They buat pada tahun Januari 2010. Di mana garis mana ni melibatkan.
If you harvest a nest before the bird could fly off, you kill the youngs, then there's no sustainability. You won't have the number of birds increasing, because without fail, these birds with good feed abundance, they will produce 3 nests a year. In the cave, if this is not maintained, the sustainability is questionable. That's why we had used to have 400 tons a year last time. Now it's only 200 tons from the cave harvested.
Swiftlets are a source of high income. There should be rules and regulations from the point of view of hygiene, from the point of view of changing the heritage landscape, and from the point of view of civic consciousness. It may disturb the peace.